Let's play ball.
And welcome in, everyone. As you haven't missed much so far, we're... We're in the first inning, no score.
Jose Iglesias.
Now here it comes. Line to shortstop, and there's one away.
Got it, Chuckie.
A moment here to take a look at the Cincinnati Reds starting lineup in this one. What do we need to know about these guys for this evening's matchup on the road, D-Row?
Matty, you take a look at this lineup. I find myself thinking back to my playing days when I knew I had the ace on the mound. It had to be win day, and when you get in a car to drive to the yard, you tell yourself, even though you felt bad about it, just get two or three. All the pressure's on the big boy to have to execute, and he usually does. Look for this lineup to try and execute and score, manufacture one or two runs early in this one.
Bases are empty, one man out. Just a tick behind for a strike. Time to check our umpires in this one. Behind the plate is Freddie Ferguson.
Hey, D-Row, you better be ready to swing, particularly at that low pitch. Freddie Ferguson, low ball umpire.
Yeah, makes it tough on the offense. I was a guy who liked the low ball, but that usually means those guys are susceptible to that slider in the dirt. You have to see the ball up, and this guy doesn't give you a chance. I know to the fans that probably looked like something good to hit, but unless you're sitting breaking ball right there, I don't care if it's middle of the plate. That's a tough pitch to pull the trigger on.
The 1-2 is swung on and missed, strike three.
It's always nice to keep a guy that has good wheels off base, and that's just what they did right there. Big strikeout, keep that guy off the base path.
Into the box now, Jesse Winker. The fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one, 1-0. Check swing, no swing, says the home plate umpire, ball two. From the windup, the 2-0 pitch. Pretty good cut there, but it's to 2-1 now.
Boy, what a time to pull the string on him. On 2-0, there's no way anyone's thinking changeup. So if you can locate it, that's pretty much unhittable.
The 2-1 is taken, ball three.
If you're at the plate right now, you have to realize who's on deck. I guarantee you something's over the heart of the plate. You have to be aggressive in the zone right here.
Good pass at that ball, just a little late, and now the count's full. Now the payoff pitch home. Is a called strike three on the corner. 1-2-3 go the Reds. And now the Blue Jays will get their initial shot. No score. Luis Castillo is on the mound here on the road for game one of the World Series. What's your take on him, Dan?
Big arm. This is a guy that when he learns to control the strike zone, particularly with his off-speed pitches, has a chance to improve in a short amount of time. Mid to high 90s fastball with a lot of movement. His breaking pitches need some refining, but if he takes that next step and starts to get that breaking stuff over, look out, this guy could get better really fast.
first pitch on its a solo home run here off the bat of Trevor Story. His first homer so far in the series, and they've taken a one-run lead.
We were wondering who was going to strike first with the long ball. What a moment for him right there. Home run in the World Series, no one can ever take that away from him.
Here's the pitch. Fastball too high to start him out here, 1-0.
Hey, if you're going to throw a pitch like that to this guy, that's right where you want to miss. Any lower, and he'll probably make you pay for it.
Bases are empty, one man out. Fastball, and that thing's a blur up there, folks. 1-1.
Hey, I love that pitch right there. Better execution after just giving up an extra base hit.
This one's down to third. Moustakas is there. Throw on to first, two gone.
Batting fourth, the right fielder, Aaron Judge.
Coming to the plate now, Aaron Judge, looking to get on base and keep this first inning alive. Now here it comes. First pitch fastball off the plate there, and it's ball one. The 1-0 home. Hit hard down the line, but a foul ball, 1-1. Two out, nobody on. Oh, break out the tape measure. That one is long gone. A solo home run there for Aaron Judge. His first homer here in the series as the Blue Jays take a 2-0 advantage.
Well, it's very early, but he's looked out of sorts from the beginning. They've already roughed him up for two homers, and they're not done yet. We'll see if he can regroup or he blows up. Could go either way at this point.
Here's George Springer. Yes, he'll take a look at ball one. Looking to get on base and keep this first inning alive. Fastball that misses.
It's a lot easier to hit when you're putting yourself in good hitters counts. This guy's done a great job not swinging at pitchers' pitches, and when he's getting the ball in his own, he's getting the barrel to it. He's been hot lately.
Chopped toward the second baseman. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. So they get a couple of runs on two hits, no errors, and no one left aboard. On now to the top half of inning number two. It's the Blue Jays 2 and the Reds nothing. New inning set to get underway, and that'll bring forth the veteran outfielder, Nicholas Castellanos.
Hey, we're still in the early stages of this one. They're only down by a couple of runs, but it's really key for this leadoff guy to try to get on and get a big inning started.
Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch.
Ball one.
The 1-0.
Two balls, no strike.
Hey, not a good spot to be, down 2-0. This guy has some serious pop at the plate. I'm expecting a big hack here.
And the pitch. Up and in. Big danger now. It's 3-0.
To be honest with you, I'm a little bit more afraid of the guy on deck than the guy that's up right now. If I'm on the mound, I want this guy up right now. He's the guy that's got to beat me.
And that misses for ball four. So it's a leadoff walk here to start the second.
Well, that is definitely not the way to start an inning. One thing to give up a walk, but to do it on four pitches is pretty alarming. He looks a little thrown off right now.
Here's the first pitch to him. In there for strike one, 0-1.
Nice job by the pitcher right there to establish himself back into the strike zone. Would have liked to have seen the hitter been a little bit more aggressive in that situation. Usually when a pitcher throws four balls in a row, that next pitch you could get super greedy right down the middle.
0-1, here it comes. A swinging strike, and now it's 0-2.
I just think after seeing both those pitches right there, 96, you have to be on the fastball or you're not going to catch up. If you're sitting off speed, that fastball is going to blow right by you.
Now a chopper to first might only get one. He's right there to second for one on the first, and it's a well-turned 3-6-1 double play, and quickly there are two gone.
That's good athleticism here by the pitcher getting off the mound. He gets the ball to first and then hustles his way over to the bag to help him wrap up the tough 3-6-1 double play.
So bases are empty here with two gone. And up next, the former World Series hero, Mike Moustakas. First pitch coming. Here it is. In there, 0-1. There's a swing and a miss says, oh my goodness, he loses the shillelagh on that one. Look out. Too high. 1-2. And it's to 2-2 now with the bases empty and two gone here in the inning. And an off-speed pitch swung on and missed, and with that, the side is retired. Reds go down quietly. They're still down. It's 2-0. At the plate, Kevin Biggio. He's set to lead off the home half of the second.
One of the keys to securing a win, they want to keep the pressure on and try to build that lead as much as they can moving into the later innings.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. And he offers it the circle change and misses 0-1.
I can't speak from experience, but that's got to feel good right there. Throwing a nasty changeup first pitch and getting a swing and a miss on it. Now he pretty much opened up any pitch in his arsenal.
And that misses 1-1. And he takes one off the inside corner for.
Yeah, he just isn't that sharp on the mound right now. Had a rough start in the first inning, and now he's falling behind out of the gate here in the second. Some adjustments need to be made, and fast.
Ball three.
Good job to work the count and put himself back in the driver's seat. Started off with one strike, and now he's got the count in his favor, 3-1.
Into his motion, here comes the 3-1.
Very rarely does a pitcher like this leave one in a location like that. That's a pitch right there he'd like to have back. He'd love to swing at that one again.
And And he takes ball four. Leadoff man's aboard here to begin the home half of the second.
Well, the reason power hitters generally draw more walks than other guys is exactly what we saw right there. Pitchers work around them and nibble the corners a lot more so they don't get burned. He made some good pitches, but he just couldn't get him to chase enough out of the zone.
From the stretch. In there, no balls and a strike.
That was a pretty good fastball after he walked the hitter previous. There was a little angry on that heater.
And here's a swing and a miss as he falls behind, nothing and two. Biggio on at first, nobody out. Not close with the off-speed pitch taken for a ball. Fastball swung on and missed for the first out.
One of the big advantages to pitching ahead in the count if you're a pitcher, because you have to cover both pitches if you're a hitter. You have to cover the off-speed and the fastball. And in a 1-2 count, you might be sitting off-speed. And what happens? He gets the fastball, and he can't catch up to the express.
Rowdy Tellez the next to bat, as he'll take a changeup here for strike one. First swings for him in this one with a runner still at first and one gone. Now a throw over, and he just manages to get his hand in. Runners on first with one down. This one's in the dirt, and it's not in time as he's in well ahead of the throw. And forget about the double play now as he'll move up to second here on the wild pitch. A 1-1 is strike two swinging.
Yeah, Matt, you see the same pitch three times in a row and you find yourself down 1-2 in the count. Your head starts to get on a swivel here. Is he coming back with it four times, or do I have to sit on something else?
Grounded to third. Throw in time at first for out number two. And with two away here in game one of the World Series, let's give you a little refresher course at the roads these two teams took to get where they are tonight. Ready now, Danny Jansen. Opportunity for him here to pick up that runner from second with two away. Here's the first pitch to him.
Even though it's early on in this one, anytime you get runners in scoring position, you'd like to knock them in.
The 0-1. Now a swing and a miss, and things are not looking real promising here. Down 0-2.
The count doesn't mean much to this batter. He's all in. He's not concerned with striking out, so he's going to get his A swing off.
Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way.
Pretty good pitch right there. Fastball in off the plate. One of the things you want to do as a pitcher, try to stand those hitters up.
The 1-2. Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul.
Got to take advantage of that pitch right there. 0-2 breaker hanging over the heart of the plate. Not going to see too many of those today.
The 1-2.
Oh, that's good.
Man, 35 pitches with only two outs in the second inning. Ideally, you'd like to have 30 or less after two innings, so he's got some catching up to do.
The 2-2. Popped him up. Home is there, and the side is retired. So no runs, no hits. No. So a big moment here, and standing in, Jesse Winker. But a single here could reduce the deficit to only one. Just gets a piece of it, strike one. Runner at second here with one man out. Set up away with the changeup, but it's 1-1.
Right guy, right spot. This is one of the better hitters in their lineup. Just the guy they want to see coming up now to get this inning going.
Late swing there on the changeup. Couldn't make up his mind, I guess. It's strike two.
This is going to be an interesting at bat. I think he has to be pitching for a strikeout here, so we'll see what kind of sequence he uses.
Grounded to the right. First, and now the Reds are down to their final out here. So digging in. Nicholas Castellanos, although there are a couple of bases open, and we'll see if they think about working around him. He's set, and the pitch. Now a swing and a ground ball. This should do it. Throw on to first is going to be in time, and the Blue Jays have started this World Series on the right foot. They're victorious here at home as this ball game is over.
Hey, it always feels good to win a baseball game, but when you can win one at home in front of your home crowd, all those fans cheering, this is a good win for this team.
This one, definitely a low-scoring affair as we get one last look at our final line score. And guys, the Blue Jays received a sterling performance in this one from the man you see there, Max Scherzer. Put that on a bubblegum card. He's our Topps player of the game.
Well, you know he wants that one pitch back that led to the lone hit, but it was pretty awesome watching him do his thing. He had guys off balance and flailing at the plate all game long, so he really was the story.
Fans, our final line score tonight. First for the Victoria.
Welcome to the show, everyone. Thanks for making us a part of your morning. Let's jump into the latest news from around the Major League. Hitter as they grab the win against the visiting Reds 2-0. They now lead the series 1-0 heading into game 2. Thanks for tuning in today. We'll be back here tomorrow and all postseason long.
Let's play ball.
And a welcome. Welcome into those just joining us. We're just getting started here in the first with no score. Now here it comes. Jose Iglesias is at the plate now as he looks at strike one.
First pitch, 7:05.
Liner in there for a base hit.
And that's hitting one-on-one right there, guys. The only way you're able to execute that type of base hit on that type of pitch is to recognize it early, stay tall, stay back, and trust the process.
In now, Leonardo Rivas, as the first pitch misses high and inside for ball one. Now a slider well off the plate, an easy take there. Pearson is a guy that's able to keep the bat off the ball. That's kind of the name of the game for a pitcher, and as a starter, it really helps him work deep into games.
Matty V, one of the toughest parts about scoring runs is bunching three or four hits together an inning, and that's one of the things this guy does really well. He's tough to hit, and he's really tough to get three or four hits off of. That's one of the reasons why he's one of the better pitchers.
Iglesias aboard here at first with nobody out. Taking all the way, and it's 3-1 now.
You maybe get two pitches a game where all the guesswork goes out the window. This is certainly that situation.
And he fouls this one off.
You don't see too many guys at this level be late on off-speed pitches right there. That tells me he was totally sitting on something else or was going automatic tape.
Swing and a miss, and they'll come all the way back from 3-0 to punch him out, one away.
Boy, that's really disappointing for a guy that has wheels, right? All he wants to do is get on base and take advantage of the strength of his game, which is his speed. But with the strikeout right there, you can't get on first base if you strike out.
Into the box, Jesse Winker, as he would look at a first pitch fastball for ball one. Runner at first here, one man out. That evens it up, 1-1.
When the guy on the mound has complete command of his off speed, especially his changeup, sometimes as a hitter you just have to give up pull side to stay on it.
And now a fastball, but he's able to hold off on it, and it's 2-1 now. And set up behind the dish is Eric Summersgill, as you see the rest of the umpiring crew there.
Yeah, Dan, we got Eric Summersgill behind the dish. Really likes to work the ball east-west. What did you like? Did you like north, south, east-west?
I thought east-west, D-World. The more I could get away with on the outside corner, inside.
And he's into second safely with a stolen base.
Good steal of second there, and that really sets up the middle of this order to drive in a run and break this scoreless ball game. Always great if you can score first early in the game.
Not where he wanted that fastball to be, and it's 3-2 now.
You would think in this situation, maybe with a base open, he'd just pitch around him and put him on first, but not with the guy in the on-deck circle. He's going to attack this hitter.
Swing and a miss on the fastball that time, out number two. So now the Reds' cleanup hitter, Nicholas Castellanos, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. From the stretch, grounded weakly toward third. A bare-handed pickup. Got him! Reds leave one. Now the Blue Jays will get their chance. No score. Tyler Molly will be on the bump for game two of the series. Dan, any thoughts?
Hey, one of the things you want to do as a pitcher is eliminate the free passes. Listen, base hits you're going to give up, but you can't walk as many as he did in his last start. And he's going to have to pitch much better if he expects a better result than this one.
Stepping in, Bo Bichette. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Now here's the pitch. Way late on the fastball for strike one. Oh, one count. Here's the pitch. Lays off the slider, and it's 1-1.
You know he's probably cheating on that inside pitch after he got jammed earlier. If you're on the mound right now, you want to try to hit that outside corner, and there's a pretty good chance you'll get him to roll over something.
Now a ball swung on and heading for the stands in right, and that'll move the count to 1-2 now. Here it comes.
Ball back in.
And a good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning. Another strikeout for him on the mound, and boy, is it fun to watch him go about his business.
No doubt, Matty. He's one of my favorites, mostly because of his stuff. You know, he can absolutely dominate on any given day because of what he offers up there. It's just nasty. There aren't many hitters that like to see this guy on the mound.
Trevor Story steps in now as he'll try to hold back on the swing, but he went around for the first strike. Wind up and the 0-1. And 1-1 as this one's in on the hands. Lifted down the line in left. And this is going to wind up a foul ball. The 1-2 is a called strike three on the corner.
The main job of the number one and two hitters is to set the middle of the order up with an opportunity to do some damage. So when you strike both of them out, you're putting yourself in a pretty good position to make it through the teeth of the lineup without a whole lot of stress.
He's ready. Here's the first offering. Yeah.
Gonna be a long day if he executes like this, punching tickets right out of the gate.
And that finds the target. Nothing in two now.
I get it. He wants to see this guy's repertoire, but now he's behind in the count. Puts himself in a tough spot to hit.
Out in front of that one, but he stays alive and will do it again on 0-2. Too high. 1-2.
Basic pitching right there. 0-2 fastball up and out of the zone. Change the eye level. Now time to go to that curveball down and away.
Again, a 1-2. They try to come in with the fastball, but it's too far in, and it's even at 2-2.
You know, these kind of at-bats can drive you crazy when you're on the mound. I mean, he's been ahead of him pretty much the whole time, but he just can't put him away. Not only that, but it's costing him a lot of bullets.
To the left side, but it's well fouled.
Man, the batter's eyes lit up right there. A hanger just a little bit out in front. Couldn't keep it there.
And he just misses inside with the fastball there.
Hey, this guy's a hard guy to put away. He's fouling off some tough pitches. 2-2 count, and he just seems to keep hanging right in there.
And he struck him out, so he was forced to make 9 pitches that at-bat, but he'll take it as the inning is over. Blue Jays go down in order. We are still scoreless.
The designated hitter, Jorge Soler.
Here's the first pitch to him. And he'll hold off on the slider here to start the at-bat. It's ball one. The 1-0 home. Finds the zone, strike one.
Very rarely does a pitcher like this leave one in a location like that. That's a pitch right there he'd like to have back. He'd love to swing at that one again.
The 1-1.
Whoa, that's up there.
That was a tempting pitch to swing at right there. A big power guy like this really wants something that he can elevate and drive out of the ballpark.
Oh, and not an easy pitch to lay off of, but he did somehow, and he's got it to 3-1. On deck, Mike Moustakas. That one bends into the zone. A strike on the breaking ball. Swing and a miss on the slider, and that's out number one.
That swing tells me he was really trying to get a pitch out front and rip it down the line, but that wasn't a great pitch to do it on. It's really not the best two-strike approach either.
The third baseman, Mike Moustakas, now. As the first pitch here's a bit high, it's ball one. The 1-0. Misses, ball two. Moustakas, or just Moose for short, who was selected in the first round back in the draft of 2007.
Yeah, Matty, they certainly got it right when they drafted this guy. He has turned himself into
a swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. But that'll be off the wall in right center. The relay. And he's going to make it there, barely, as he's into second base with a double. Alex Blandino will try and loosen up here as he'll be the runner at second base following the injury. Stepping in now, Nick Senzel. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. Red center fielder in front with a 2-0 count. Ready with the 2-0 pitch. And a swing through on an off-speed pitch. Looked like he was actually a little late on that one. Sure took a healthy hack that time. Could have been 3-1. Instead, it's 2-2. No score here as we play inning number two. Strike three on a pitch in the dirt. And the throw is made to record the second out of the inning.
Good pitch there. That was a nice job by his battery mate to complete the play first after the ball hit the dirt.
So that'll bring up C.J. Krohn, runner in scoring position with two gone. He comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. And that's in there for strike one. Runner in scoring position at second with two down. In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. Krohn, a California-born ball player. He was a first-round pick back in 2011.
Yeah, he has turned himself into a really nice ball player. I wouldn't put him on the superstar level, but you know what? They didn't miss with this pick either. You go in the high rounds and you carve out a career the way this guy has, nice pick.
A swing and a miss as he chased with two strikes, and that will retire the side. One left for Cincinnati. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Alex Blandino is going to go ahead and stay in the ball game and play third down.
For the Reds, now playing third base, number zero.
Bottom of the inning now, and standing in is the veteran outfielder, Aaron Judge. First offering on its way.
Count 1-0.
The 1-0 home is laid off, but in there for strike one. A swing and a ground ball to third. Throw pulls the first baseman off the bag. And this will go down as an E5, as you can see the exasperation on his face. So it's a runner at first as a result of the throwing error. And that'll bring forth the veteran outfielder, George Springer. First pitch on its way. Starts him out with a slider for a strike. Gets him to pop it up on the right side of the infield. Prone is under it, and he's got it for the first down.
Batting fifth, the second baseman, Kevin Biggio.
Standing in, Kevin Biggio. He'll get to take his first cuts here. From the stretch.
Oh, that's good.
Straightened him up there on that fastball. It's 1-2 now.
With the way this guy's throwing on the mound, you cannot be chasing. You have to set your sights a little bit lower and control the strike zone.
The 1-2. This is skied into the air to straightaway center. Senzel is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first.
That is done. The left fielder, Lourdes Gurriel.
From the stretch, here's the pitch. Swung on and lifted in the air to left center. Senzel makes the play, and the side is retired. One left for Toronto, who move to the third with no score. Batting, Davey Grillon, and he'll start out their half of the third, top of the order to follow.
Three.
Your attention, please. Now pitching for the Blue Jays, number 51, Ken. Your attention, please.
He's out.
He's running it first for the Reds.
Three.
Number 16, Michael Ciani.
So striding in, Nick Senzel, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. Trying to hold the lead, here's the delivery. And here's a fastball called for strike one.
The Reds have been searching for that big hit all game long. Let's hope they can get it. They're starting to run out of time. It's about time for something to happen.
High in the air and drifting out to shallow center. Springer coming on. He gets there to make the play, and that ends the inning. A good performance there by the Toronto bullpen. Home half of the eighth straight ahead. The Jays are out in front, 3-2. Amir Garrett is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom eight.
Number 50, Amir Garrett.
Number 4 is into the ballgame now as he'll take over out in left field.
Number 4.
Bottom of inning number 8 set to go, and that'll bring in the second baseman, Kevin Biggio.
Kevin Biggio.
He's set. Here it comes. And this is taken outside for ball one. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. The 1-0 home. Now he gets on top of one here and chops it foul right at home plate. Fastball taken inside for a ball. 2-1 now. Fouled off. Fastball called. Strike three. And there's the first out of the inning.
People always talk about how important getting the leadoff men on base is, and it's true. So in the eighth inning of a one-run game, that's a really nice job of attacking a hitter and sending him packing.
Standing in now, Lourdes Gurriel. As the first pitch to him runs a bit inside for ball one. He's 2-for-3 and looking for more here. To the Jays left fielder. fouled away. This one, everything we could have hoped for. 3-2 in inning number 8. Maybe a little jumpy there as he swings through the fastball. And he strikes him out as well. So make it
behind because none of that matters if he can clutch up when it really counts.
Looking to keep this a one-run game, the pitch.
One and one.
Man, that's one of those. How could you not swing at that one? A good take there on that pitch.
The set and the 1-1. Two out here and a runner at second. And he lays off the fastball away, so it's 2-2 now. He's able to ride this one high and deep toward right center. A ball that's carrying. But he has no chance to make the play. It's off the wall.
Dan, that's a huge insurance run right there. Has to feel good as a hitter right there to not only get a ribby knock, but to give your team a little bit of breathing.
It does, and it makes your pitcher go out there with a little bit more free and easy frame of mind instead of going in a one-run game where every pitch is so important. You're one pitch away from a solo tying the game up. That's not the case now.
Digging in, Bo Bichette. On the night, he's 2-for-4 with a pair of singles. Trying to keep the deficit right where it is, the pitch. Here's a slider to start things out, looked at for ball one.
Somebody's getting frustrated. He's not used to getting hit around like this.
The 1-0. Well hit to right, but a foul ball. Runner in scoring position at second with two down. Right back to him on the mound. And he'll flip it onto first, and with it, that ends the inning. Blue Jays forced to settle for just the one. Game two heads to the ninth inning. Toronto leads this one 4-2. Coming to the plate now, CJ Krohn. He's the one to start off the ninth inning with his guys in danger of going down 2-0 if they can't rally. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Ninth inning begins as the first pitch is taken for ball one. A 1-1 count to the Reds' first baseman. Swing and a miss as he pulled the string on him. 1-2. And a swing and a miss. Good pitch there for the first out here in the ninth. Stepping up now, Davey Grillon is working on a 1-for-3 thus far. From the stretch. Now an off-speed pitch gets the outside. It's a called strike.
Hey, a changeup can be a pretty good pitch on the first pitch. Kind of slow down a good fastball hitter.
behind 0-2 now. Might have been looking to find that outside corner, but he couldn't quite get it there. It's 1-2.
He wasn't even close to swinging right there. That was a stone-cold take.
Got him swinging. Chased it well out of the zone, and there are two gone. Here's the shortstop now, Jose Iglesias. His career history with Roberto Osuna, he's a .375 hitter. He also has one home run. First pitch on its way. Fastball in there for a called strike. One and one to the Reds' leadoff man.
You know he wants that on the mound, especially if it would have made the count 0-2. Didn't get it, though, so now you have to make another quality pitch on 1-1.
Now the pitch. And a fastball in the dirt that's taken for a ball. Bases are empty here with two men out. And it's fouled away. Close to 50,000 on their feet here in Toronto. Swing and a miss. He struck him out, and that'll do it here as the ball game is over.
Yeah, they needed him a little bit earlier in this one, but he takes the mound in the eighth and records the final four outs. Four out save. Job well done.
Before we take our leave, time for a look at our final line score here in what turned out to be a close two-run victory. Well, we watched a really solid starting pitching performance, kept the opposition at bay, and as a result, he's our top player of the game.
Yeah, I thought he pitched really well. He wasn't necessarily dominant, but turned in a good, solid effort and definitely was a factor in the win here.
Four to two, the final score tonight. The Jays get the win to jump out to a 2-0 series lead. Nate Pearson earns the victory on the mound. So that's a wrap here tonight. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and Heidi Watney, this is Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, find us on Twitter at MLB The Show.
Fans, our final line score tonight. First for the victorious Blue Jays, 4 runs on 11 hits. No errors, they left 12 men on base. For the Reds, 2 runs on 8 hits. 1 error, they left 12 men on base. Time of the ball game, 2 hours and 50 minutes. Tonight's paid attendance at Rogers Center, 49,282. The Blue Jays thank you for your continued...
Let's play ball.
Want to welcome those of you just tuning in. We're in the first inning with two away. Striding into the box, Bo Bichette, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. Pitch on the way. Right down Broadway that time. Strike one. Plate, one ball, one strike. Here's the 1-1 pitch.
Backed up 1-2.
And he got him. 1-2-3 go the Blue Jays. And now the Reds will get their first opportunity. No score. Hyunjin Ryu gets the ball in game three of the series. What do you have for us on him, Danny?
Hey, you don't see a lot of guys that have five pitches, right? Sometimes it's hard to master even two or three, but if you can master five like he has, he'll be in pretty good shape.
All right, guys, time for a look at how the Toronto Blue Jays set up on defense today. And can we focus on George Springer, one of the more dynamic outfielders in our sport? He will leave his feet. He's got a cannon for an arm, not afraid to dive in and say hi to the fans if a ball's going near there, too. Do not test this guy's arm.
Leading off for the Reds, the shortstop, first pass, is right there. Fans, a reminder to stop by the stadium store, located on the main concourse, to pick up all of your World Series souvenirs. Whether you're looking for hats, shirts, jerseys, outerwear, we've got a full line of products to suit your needs. Be sure to stop by tonight. fans, theshownation.com is the only address you need for everything you want to know about MLB The Show. Keep updated with blogs and news straight from the source. Take part in interactive message boards, track the community market, and so much more. Don't forget, the site for all things The Show is theshownation.com.
A reminder, fans, that all games this season will be broadcast in Spanish on AM 1440 by the announcing team of Jason Villa and Luis Martinez.